Congratulations, Tony and Patricia. Yes. Well, you'll have a good party when it all comes together, won't you? We all ease down the lockdown. Ease down. Yes, yeah, something like that. Yes. Ease a lockdown.
Yes.
Right.
Let's move on to the pictures, Sally. Yes. Graham Edwards photographed the morning sky in Burnham in West Sussex. Lovely.
My dick took this shot of the blue skies and daffodils in Reading.
Through the day today, we had scenes like this, particularly down in parts of Dorset, where we did have some rain, but most places saw dry conditions, fairly cloudy scenes. So looking over Pagham Harbour, this picture was captured by one of our weather watchers. But we did have blue skies in some places. In the majority of places across the south, we saw scenes like this in Farnham and Surrey. And we'll see scenes like this through the course of tomorrow. Lots of sunshine, allowing temperatures to rise higher than today, and the winds will be a lot lighter. So the winds will start to ease overnight tonight. We'll have varying amounts of cloud, particularly along the south coast and for the Isle of Wight. Clear skies for some of us, so temperatures may fall below freezing. So in some areas, there is the slight risk we could have a little bit of a frost first thing tomorrow morning. Now, through the day tomorrow, there will be varying amounts of cloud, slightly more cloud for the south coast initially, but that will start to burn back. And with the strength of the sun at this time of year, temperatures will be higher than today. And that's because the winds will be slightly lighter. We could see highs tomorrow of 19, possibly 20, maybe 21 degrees, and warmer still come Thursday. But tomorrow night, we do it all again. Under clearing skies, temperatures will fall away. So in very sheltered spots for northernmost areas, there is the risk we could have a little bit of a frost first thing on Thursday morning. Now, high pressure dominates our weather through Thursday. It starts to build in even further. The isobars are wide, so we'll have fairly light winds. And temperatures could be slightly higher than today and tomorrow, possibly up to around 21, maybe 22 Celsius. The very slim chance of a shower for western parts of the country. Now, here's the outlook for the rest of the week. We are looking at a good deal of warm sunshine, high UV levels through the course of Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday, and high pollen levels as well. Temperatures will start to slowly climb up to around 23, 24, maybe even 25 Celsius. Now, the warmest of the days are expected through Friday and also Saturday. But then comes Sunday, it's all changed because we have a weather front. That's a band of rain moving southwards Saturday night. That behind it will be cooler air. So introducing cooler air, temperatures drop by 8 to 12 degrees on Sunday. So it will feel noticeably cooler and noticeably cooler for the start of next week. Sally.
Thanks, Alexis. Let's finish up with the main headline for you. The number of deaths from coronavirus in the UK is now the highest in Europe and the second highest in the world after the United States. We have more tonight, of course, at 10:30. And we've got a big finish now because we are going to leave you with our talented weather girls. Go, go, go. We're back at 10:30. Have a good evening. Bye-bye.